Hello and welcome to the Vintage Girl Next Door. My name is Lacey Fay, and today I am going to do a little tutorial on this vintage Valentine's Day makeup and hair. And I also have a few vintage Valentine's outfits to try on. So if you want to see that, then keep on watching. Hi. Okay, we're going to get started on some Valentine's Day makeup. So first we're going to do some foundation. And I'm going to use CoverGirl Healthy Elixir in Ivory. This is the lightest shade, but it's too dark for me. So I mix it with White, LA Girl, Pro Coverage HD, and just kind of mix it here on the back of my hand. Okay, we are going to put it on our face. I already used primer, so we're just going straight into it. Your mighty pen is stirring. Okay, and I've got my damp sponge. It is the Eco Tools beauty sponge. Cooing out in delight, we'll form a bona fide couplet tonight. More concealer. My favorite, Tarte Shape Tape. I have the shade Fair Neutral. And I usually do like the center of my face and also under my eyes. Now that we look sufficiently crazy, we'll blend it out. Your mighty pen is stirring. And now your grammar pussy's purring. Now we will set it. This is my favorite also setting powder, RCMA No Color Powder. It's just in a weird container, so I just tap some out into the sleeve. Just set it with my damp sponge. I feel like that's the very best way for me to not get creasing under my eyes, because I tend to get creasing if I don't do it this way. And also on my forehead. I set that area with the sponge and my no color powder, but I like to set my cheeks with a different powder. I use the Besame Cosmetics Ever After Translucent Pearl Powder, and it is this from their Snow White collection. So cute. Just to get a little bit. Show me all gosh. Can do. No syntax will be levy. Okay. Our eyebrows are definitely gonna need this mirror a little bit closer, so I'm sorry. You're gonna have to see it for a second. So I use a few different things for my brows. Like three. So the first thing we're going to do is Anastasia Beverly Hills Dip Brow in the shade Auburn. Just going to load that up on our angle brush. And go in for some brows. You're just my type face.
atomic sounds of all the fun. The way you simile like a brightly burning sun. Your dangling participle is my favorite part of speech.
If you couldn't tell, the makeup style and kind of aesthetic that I go for is 1950s, and so that is a more sculpted brow with a very pronounced arch. So that is what we're drawing.
And now your grammar pauses, hurry. Hear my heart cooing out in delight that we formed a bona fide couplet tonight. This kitten knows you went from good to verse, perfecting purple prose. You know that I am old beside your simple painted beat.
So now I've got that step on, and then because my hair is quite bright, I like to add some brighter orange to my brows. So I use Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette, and the shade is this one. I hope you can see. Realgar. Realgar. And so then I just use some of that. It's like a pretty bright orange powder. And I use that to add a little bit of more, a little bit more color. Okay. So once we are done with that, then I just set them with this e.l.f. brow kit in light, and I'm just using the wax one to set these wily hairs in place. Okay, I think that we better warm up the rest of the face because yikes. So I don't do a whole lot of contour, but I do a little, and I'm just gonna use the actually the brow kit, the e.l.f. brow kit in light, the powder side, to do a little bit of cheek contour. Contouring definitely wasn't a big thing in the 50s or a thing at all, but I do like the way a slight contour looks on my face. Now we're going with some blush. That will help us. And I have Besame Cosmetics blush, and the shade is Sweet Pink. Look how pretty. I just love it. Love their packaging. Love almost all of their products. Definitely their blush is one of my favorite. We're gonna start apples of the cheeks and go back from there. I usually kind of go a little bit overboard with the blush. I just really like it. Okay, one side looks more than the other. Build it up. Okay. Now, highlighting also wasn't a big thing in the 50s. but I do like the way a little highlight looks, so we're going to do a little one. And I have the Mary Luminizer by The Balm. I'm just going to dust a little bit. I don't know if you can see it on the camera or not, but just adds a little bit of a shimmery glow. Pretty. Okay. Okay, let's do some eyeshadow. And this is kind of the more Valentine's-y part. So first I go in with a white shade. Mine is almost gone, but it's by Sugar Pill, and the color is Tako, T-A-K-O. So we're doing white on the lid and on just under the brow bone. Okay, and the star of our Valentine's Day eye look is going to be that same Modern Renaissance palette. There is such pretty warm reds and purples and pink colors in here, so we are going to do it. So I'm just going to take a fluffy brush. I'm going to do this purplish, light purplish. It's called Buon Fresco. We're going to put that in the crease. Kind of above it and in it. So it's going to be our little transition color. Okay, probably going to have to get the mirror gun. But now I'm going to go in with this bright, pretty cranberry-ish shade called Love Letter. Really just needs such a tiny amount of these shadows because they are so super pigmented. Focusing more on the outer. And then I think I want to deepen that crease a little bit more. So I'm going to go in with this one, Antique Bronze. Just on the outer a bit. So I like how that's looking. I'm just going to blend it even more. And go back to that same fluffy brush and just blend it. Perfect. Now we're going to do a little inner corner highlight, and we're going to use this one, Vermeer. Now we are going to do some eyeliner, and my favorite liquid eyeliner is this one. It's called Schwing by The Balm. So I get the lid lined first, inner corner start thin, and then thicker as you go out. And now we will do the wing. And I like a bit of a more dramatic wing. You can definitely go shorter on this if you want. Out the the seal. Okay. I don't hate it, so we will continue. So, we've got our winged liner, and the other thing that is super important for a vintage 50s look is eyelashes. So we are going to do some eyelashes. We've got our eyelashes. This is a new pair. I haven't tried this kind before, but I thought they looked pretty. And it's the Ardell Double Demi Wispy. So first of all, we are going to take our glue. And if you don't know, best eyelash glue ever is Kiss. This kind, strip lash adhesive with aloe. It is literally the best ever. So we're gonna get that on our lash band. Do this part first, and then while I'm waiting for my glue to dry, then I put mascara. Curl our eyelashes. I know that you can't see them because they are little baby nothing eyelashes. That's why I wear falsies. Well, that's not the only reason I love how falsies look. So because I wear falsies every day, I really don't put much into mascara. Right now I'm just using the good old fashioned Maybelline Great Lash. And basically I just use it to blend so that my eyelashes blend in better with the falsies. So I like to also take a white eyeliner pencil and line my inner waterline with it. Makes your eyes, the whites of your eyes look whiter and kind of opens up the eye a little bit more. Okay, it looks like our glue is ready. So we'll stick this lash on. Your mighty pen is stirring. I like these. I guess I've never worn these specific lashes before, but I think they're pretty. And they feel pretty good comfort-wise. Well, that's always good. We doubled our entendres. You wrapped me in your rhyme. Your assonance so tight can pass me any time. Your irony is hard again. It's time to steam the sheen. Okay, perfect. Now, no Valentine's Day look is complete without red lipstick. I am going to use this one, Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink in the shade Pioneer. So this is the makeup look.